might succeed in doing so. Gun in Action kicks up along the inside and after 250 metres holds out That's True, which now drops in behind it to the fence. 4 metres away, third was Slim Elzo. Pops the Light, it's outside. Westburn Star working hard, 3 wide, will go up into the death seat shortly. Moonfellow was 2 back on the outside for the moment. Over on the inside was Ronzel Rooster, then Copper Mate, 3rd last. 2nd last, the fence, Kelly Franco, and last of all was Lucatross. Down the straight they go with 2 circuits left to travel, and Gun in Action in front. Won the early battle for the lead and leads now by 4 metres to Westburn Star, who has to pace without cover. 3rd, the inside, That's True. 2 metres away, Pops Delight, now 1 by 1. The favourite, Slim Elzo, badly hemmed up for the moment, 3 back on the rail. On its outside as they work to the back was Moonfella. 4 back the fence, Ronzel Rooster, then Copper Mate, 3rd last the outside. Lucatross was 2nd last, and Kelly Franco easing back to the tail of the field looks as if it's going to hook around them. Down the back straight, 20 metres would cover up 1st from last. They have a little bit under a mile left to run, and Gun in Action slows them up in front. Leads by 3 metres, and 2nd placing Westburn Star on the outside of That's True. 1 by 1, Pops Delight. Here's Kelly Franco letting go from the rear, 3 wide. Slim Elzo still 3 back on the fence, 4th last, Moonfella. Ronzel Rooster, 5 back on the rail, about 2 metres to Copper Mate, and last of all, Lucatross. Running off the back, 1,200 metres to travel, and Gun in Action in front. Leads by 3 or 4 metres as Kelly Franco works around the outside, will soon be in the death. Westburn Star's in the middle for the moment, That's True on the leader's back. Then Pops Delight, 5th, and on the inside was Slim Elzo. He'll need a lot of luck from there, the favourite. Then Moonfella outside, Ronzel Rooster, Copper Mate, and last of all was Lucatross. Down the straight with a circuit left to go. Gun in Action in front, Kelly Franco worked to his wheel. 2 metres away the fence, That's True, 3rd, 4th, Westburn Star, 1 by 1. Then Slim Elzo, 3 back on the inside of Pops Delight. 3rd last over on the inside was, as they go out of the straight, Ronzel Rooster from Copper Mate, Moonfella in front of it, Lucatross at the rear. Inside the 750 metres point, Gun in Action led 2 metres. Kelly Franco breathes down his neck, 2nd. 3rd, the inside, That's True. In 4th placing as they run down the back straight, Westburn Star, followed by Slim Elzo, Pops Delight. Back behind them was Moonfella, about to be hooked out 3 deep. Ronzel Rooster gets off the fence. Lucatross switches back to the rail, and Copper Mate last of all. 450 metres to go. Gun in Action got away 4 metres in front of Kelly Franco. That's True, tapped up on the inside, but it can't get out for the moment. Sprinting around the outside was Pops Delight, running on strongly. And around them also was Copper Mate, but the leader gave them the slip. Gun in Action up to the turn. He shot away 10 metres in front. Kelly Franco's gone. That's True, Pops Delight, Copper Mate battling on for the miners, and then Slim Elzo getting into the clear. But Gun in Action has kicked away. 100 metres to go. Gun in Action's about 10 or 15 metres in front and in no danger of defeat. He's going to bolt in. Big performance by Gun in Action. That's True, hanging on for 2nd. Pops Delight wearing him down for that minor end. But Gun in Action's won 12 metres to That's True. 3rd, Pops Delight, then Lucatross, which rattled home at the finish. Slim Elzo hardly ever saw daylight. Then Copper Mate, followed by Moonfella, Ronzel Rooster, Kelly Franco, disappointing. And back of the tail of the field was Westburn Star.
Right, 3-4-6 there, race one at Mooney Valley. It's tight for 2nd, though. Oh.
Blue light flashing, a good even start to, and Beckadoon and Uptown Fella beat them out. Balakir again, Croc began well. All one put in a bad one was Brilo, dropped out the last, and on settling cloudy century was 2nd last. Also back near the tail was Mobile Beauty and Carnival Arcade at the corner the first time around. And Beckadoon and Uptown Fella matching strides in front over Madawi Prince, followed then by Miss Mandy Summersby Warrior. Carnival Arcade was next. They were followed then by Cloudy Century, back in the field to Balakir again. Gamecock and Brilo brought up the rear. Down to the judge they travel with 2 to go, and Beckadoon the leader. A length to Uptown Fella, Madawi Prince going up to challenge. Miss Mandy easing off the fence, forcing Summersby Warrior out wider. Mobile Beauty going up on the inside of Carnival Arcade. They were followed by Cloudy Century, Balakira Gamecock, and Brilo brought up the rear. Down the back in the final of the pace, and Beckadoon the leader. A half a length to Madawi Prince. Uptown Fella was next, followed by Summersby Warrior. Miss Mandy poking up along the rail, so too Mobile Beauty on the inside of Carnival Arcade. Cloudy Century was next from Balakira Gamecock, and Brilo brought up the rear. In this order they leave the back and move to the turn, a lap and a quarter before them in the final of the pace, and it's Beckadoon the leader ahead to the good of Madawi Prince, 3rd, Uptown Fella, followed then by Miss Mandy, Summersby Warrior, Mobile Beauty, Cloudy Century unwinding a big run right up around the outside. Back in the field to Carnival Arcade, and Balakira Gamecock was last of all. Put in a bad one, Balakira Gamecock. At the bell, 1 second of the course to go, and Cloudy Century's got to the lead over Madawi Prince, followed by Beckadoon, Uptown Fella, Miss Mandy, Mobile Beauty, Summersby Warrior, Brilo, Carnival Arcade, and Balakira Gamecock. Down the back they travel, 500 out of Madawi Prince. Crimson Cloudy Century matching strides in front. Well clear of Mobile Beauty. Rattling on next was Beckadoon, who's gone uptown fella. Miss Mandy under pressure from one there was Braille-O Carnival Arcade. Somersby Warrior and Balakira Gamecock. They leave the back and move to the turn. 350 out, Madawi, Prince Alina. Mobile Beauty, the big danger, moving up nicely around the outside, followed then by Cloudy Century. Uptown fella, Beckadoon and Miss Mandy, but around the corner, it's Madawi Prince and Mobile Beauty having to theirself, both drivers at work with a stick. Madawi Prince on the inside, Mobile Beauty on the outside. McDean getting everything out of Madawi Prince. Mobile Beauty won't pick it up, and Madawi Prince won the money. Mobile Beauty second, Cloudy Century third, followed by Uptown fella, Beckadoon. Next to go down, Brylo, Miss Mandy, Carnival Arcade, Balakira Gamecock, and last home in the pace, Somersby Warrior.
All right, 4.79 there, race three at Maitland, 4.79 with Madawi Prince.
Today at $1.50, two's on the Queensland TAB. He's resuming from a break. He's trying to win his first race at a mile here. Lights on, racing. Sam Isaacs and Happy Heldon drop back after the start, and Sentimental Fella and Cavalier Savante both came out very quickly. Bowyer goes looking for the lead with Cavalier Savante, and Dux is content to hand up on Sentimental Fella, and Cavalier Savante leads around the first bend by two to Sentimental Fella, two lengths to Jungle Habits, then Happy Heldon, and Sam Isaacs is last of the five, and the Quintetta and Indian File at the end of the first quarter. Past the 1200 metres pole, and Cavalier Savante, the favourite, chose the way. 28.4 the first split. Sentimental Fella second, sitting on the back of the leader, and he is Happy coming up deep now. She moves up in the breeze on the outside of Jungle Habits, and Sam Isaacs peels away from the fence and latches onto the back of Happy Heldon. They've left the bell behind. It's Cavalier Savante in front at the 900 metres mark. Leads by more than a length of a Sentimental Fella, and a neck to Happy Heldon on the outside. Sam Isaac sitting on the back of Happy Heldon, and Jungle Habits a neck away, and last of the five at the Tea Tree, 750 to run. He got away with an easy quarter, Cavalier Savante, 32.1 the second section, and at the 650 he's more than a length in front of Happy Heldon. Sentimental Fellow third, locked in on the rail. Sam Isaac's fourth, still on the back of Double H, and Jungle Habits is last as they travel onto the top corner. Cavalier Savante shows the way at the 400 metres peg. He's still more than a length in front of Happy Heldon. Third quarter was 28.7. Sentimental Fellas third, then Sam Isaacs and Jungle Habits, but Cavalier Savante leads onto the final corner. Now Bowyer clicks him up, and Cavalier Savante is two in front of Happy Heldon. Sentimental Fella under pressure from Sam Isaacs. Cavalier Savante in front with 50 metres left to run, and the miles know who do tonight. Cavalier Savante wins the money from Happy Heldon and Sentimental Fella, then Jungle Habits and Sam Isaacs last of all. 157.3 to start the night.
Yeah, okay, well, there was no hoodoo, was it, as Terry mentioned?
The start badly was River Ridge, and moving up in the middle was Just Melanie. Charging through was Tammy Lynn. Out of the straight, Peerless Jethro Hazard, and has raced away by two. Just Melanie second. The outside third was Tammy Lynn, followed by Burning Lucky between them. Two further back to Coal Black, followed second last by Calypso Boy, and three last was River Ridge. At the top turn, Peerless Jethro raced out by six. Second, Tammy Lynn. Third was Burning Lucky, followed by Coal Black and Just Melanie. But it's a breeze for Peerless Jethro racing right away, and Peerless Jethro wins by six. Second, Tammy Lynn, just in front of Burning Lucky third. Behind those came Just Melanie from Calypso Boy, Coal Black, and one of the last ones in was River Ridge.
Right, 1, 6, and 4, race two at Penrith.
Play, got the flare out, wide has begun quickly. It'll look for the lead, and I think it's got the speed. Miss Innocence has gone for a gallop shortly after the start. Clever Son was on the back of Miss Innocence and had to ease, and out the back early was Happy Holiday. On settling and got the flare has gone to the clear lead. By 5 or 6 metres, Young Island on the inside, Take More Care, fly past out wide going forward. Now next along on the outside, Call the Shots, but it's right up on the steel. QC Scott on the rails, then 4 metres to Earl Nugent in front of Clever Son. Another 4 metres away then to Happy Holiday, and settling 20 metres back at the tail was Miss Innocence. Down the straight they race the first time. They've got two to run, got the flare. 3 metres in front of, in second placing, Fly Past. Take More Care behind the leader. The lead time not quick. It's only 47.7. 1 by 1, Young Island. QC Scott on the inside. Another 4 metres then to Call the Shots. No moves from either favourite. Earl Nugent still in front of Clever Son. Going to the inside. Happy Holiday, and still 20 metres or more away to Miss Innocence at the tail. Down the back they race, and the leader got the flare. Still 4 metres, the good of Fly Pass, which has worked in the run. On the inside, Take More Care, Young Islands in the 1-1. QC Scott on its inside, another 4 metres to call the shots. Then Happy Holiday, still sitting Earl Nugent and Clever Son, neither willing to go, and Miss Innocence will struggle to tack on. Halfway around the top turn, just over a lap and a quarter left to run, and this leader's had a very easy run, got the flare. It's 4 metres to Fly Past. Earl Nugent comes, but Call the Shots moves in front of it. Nizay Straighten got the flare, led from Fly Past. Call the Shots moving up quickly out three wide. Earl Nugent's got the cart home. Back on the inside, Take More Care. Young Island now in the centre. On the inside, QC Scott needs a lot of luck. Still well out of it, Clever Son from Happy Holiday. Miss Innocence is losing ground. They make their way towards the back straight, and the leader got the flare, held together 3 metres in front of Fly Past. Out three wide, Call the Shots, Take More Care behind them. Young Island drops out sharply there. Earl Nugent on the outside, QC Scott comes one off. Then Clever Son, Happy Holiday, Young Island dropping out of it. Down the back, got the flare, still held together by a couple. Two Call the Shots, Fly Past in the centre. Earl Nugent will come four wide shortly. Take More Care in behind them. The leader's still got a kick left. Then QC Scott held up. Clever Son's got the big job to do. Earl Newton takes off four wide, halfway around the turn. She's still got a grip on the leader, got the flare. 4 metres in front of Take More Care. Earl Nugent and now Clever Son right around the outside. The leader kicks. Got the flare in front. Earl Nugent and Clever Son are motoring home. Got the flare 4 metres in front. Clever Son, Earl Nugent. Here's a go. Clever Son on the outside's done best. A big win. Clever Son has beaten, got the flare, and Earl Nugent in a great go for the first. 10 or 12 metres, Take More Care. Then Fly Past, QC Scott. Further back, Happy Holiday, Call the Shots, Young Island and Miss Innocence.
All right, photo there. Gee whiz, it came down the outside with a real run, didn't it? That one on the Clever Son, number 9. Now, things are looking pretty nice out there at Wendy Park for a good night of greyhound racing this evening. Once again, let's take you out.
By the yellow, they're set to go, the opening event. Racing Top Glee missed it. Coming out fast on the outside was Speed Hump, is going to cross and lead them. Plug for Me is second. Moving up along the rails then was Striking Opal at the first corner. White on the track, Caroline Bale, then Tomorong, followed by Rumours Fly and Royal Joker. Speed Hump leads up the back, is out by four lengths to Striking Opal. Top Glee is running on powerfully. Four to Tomorong, Plug for Me and Rumours Fly. On the corner, Speed Hump's the leader, but here comes Top Glee. The leader was Speed Hump. Top Glee wearing it down. Top Glee goes to the lead. And Top Glee, the favourites, won the first. Speed Hump second. Getting up for third was Striking Opal, Plug for Me, Royal Joker. Then Rumours Fly. Next to last was Tomorong and Caroline Bale.
Number 2, Top Glee, the winner there in Sydney. Now let's have a look.
I'm Paul Miller from the Harndorf Inn Hotel. Harndorf is a small German settlement village situated in the Adelaide Hills. It's only 30 minutes drive from the GPO. Our hotel offers a unique traditional environment, warm, friendly atmosphere, complemented by excellent meals. So next time you're in town, come and join us.
Stand by, country music fans. Here's the best of country number ones.
I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burned.
With Merle Haggard and Willie Nelson.
Blue eyes crying in the rain.
Tanya Tucker and Kenny Rogers.
Picked a fine time to lead me, Lucy.
The best of country number ones.
Four hungry children and a crop in.
With Dolly Parton and Glenn Campbell.
I am a lineman for the county.
Maybe your babies.
The Judds, Marty Robbins, Roger Miller and more.
Devil woman, let me be and leave me alone. I want to go home.
Man of means.
Get the best of country number ones.
King of the road.
Now, Top Glee at 2:41.
All set to go. Favourite Quick Kiwi drawn one. There's the green light. They're away and trotting. Campbell King was the best to break the line. Beginning fairly fast was Our Navy's Pride in search for the lead. The favourite Quick Kiwi kicking up along the rails. White out around the track was the South Australian Star Someday going forward. Our Navy's Pride in front of the first turn, though. And our Navy's Pride leads by a metre. Star Someday's wide out and persisting to go forward. And third placing the favourite, Quick Kiwi, one by one was Campbell King. Then came Nellie Lewis on the outside of Aztec Spring, about 4 metres away, Chrysantic. 6 metres away, Rolleston Ladd and Kushler Bay sneaking up on the rail at the tail of the field. The field of nine sweep down the straight with two circuits to go, and our Navy's Pride in his favourite role. He leads by 3 metres. In second placing was Star Someday. Letting go from the tail of the field was Chrysantic. Goes forward three wide. Now, Quick Kiwi's on the back of the leader, our Navy's Pride. One by one was Campbell King, Aztec Spring three back the fence. Then came Nellie Lewis, Kushler Bay second last, and Rolleston Ladd at the tail. Out of the straight, 1,700 metres to travel, and our Navy's Pride on top, led by 2 metres. Chrysantic working three wide for the moment to get around Star Someday into the death. He'll eventually succeed in doing so, so Star Someday is going to get the 1-1. Quick Kiwi still tracking up our Navy's Pride. Back in fifth position on the outside, Campbell King on the fence, Aztec Spring with the pink colours. A length away behind it, Nellie Lewis, and then Kushler Bay, and last of all, Rolleston Ladd, but it's peeling off three wide. 1,350 metres to travel. Our Navy's Pride by 3 metres. Second was Chrysantic. Third, the inside, Quick Kiwi. One by one was Star Someday. Rolleston Ladd going around them three wide. Aztec Spring the fence, and then came Campbell King. Around them out three wide, Nellie Lewis gets onto the back of Rolleston Ladd and Kushler Bay at the tail of the field. They wheel the corner now with about 1,200 metres to run, and our Navy's Pride led by 2 metres. Rolleston Ladd worked up three wide to go to second. On its back, Nellie Lewis. In the middle, Chrysantic. On the fence behind the leader was Quick Kiwi. He'll need some luck to get out from there. Then Aztec Spring back in about sixth position. Out wider on the track, Star Someday, then Campbell King, and last of all, Kushler Bay. Out of the straight they go. 750 metres left to travel. Our Navy's Pride on top by 2 metres to Rolleston Ladd. Quick Kiwi's third the inside. Nellie Lewis was three wide, just hanging for a stride or two there. Then Aztec Spring, Chrysantic the middle. Out four wide for the moment, Star Someday, and then Kushler Bay and Campbell King. Down the back straight for the final time, 600 metres to travel. Our Navy's Pride on top hasn't put a foot wrong, led 2 metres to Rolleston Ladd. Here's Nellie Lewis challenging out three deep. Quick Kiwi needs a run. Then Star Someday and Campbell King running on from the tail of the field. Aztec Spring third last. And then Kushler Bay and dropping out of it, Chrysantic. Off the back now, 400 metres left to go. Our Navy's Pride under pressure. Rolleston Ladd went to the front. Nellie Lewis is going with it. Running on now, Quick Kiwis into the clear and challenging very fast. Then Campbell King, Aztec Spring and Kushler Bay. Up to the turn, Rolleston Ladd in front with a favourite. Quick Kiwi went up quickly on the outside. They turn together 8 metres in front of Nellie Lewis, dropping out of it sharply, and then Kushler Bay. It's a race in two with Quick Kiwi taking the lead. 100 metres left to go. He drew away from Rolleston Ladd. Quick Kiwi in front. He's drawn clear, and Quick Kiwi's going on to score. Quick Kiwi, good effort, wins 6 metres, Rolleston Ladd. 8 metres away, Kushler Bay running on for third, and then Campbell King. They were followed in by our Navy's Pride, Nellie Lewis. Then Aztec Spring, a long break in the field, then to Star Someday. Didn't have the best of luck, nor did Nellie Lewis, and Chrysantic was back at the tail.
OK, 1-8 and 10 there at Moonee Valley, 1-8 and 10.
All set. Ready for the third. Final check of the Toad favourite. 3.10, 1.30 for five. Duchess Tiffany and Mistera at 3.90. They're set. Ready for start and racing. Beginning well on the outside was Reebok Glass. Charging up along the fence was Good Time Idol, followed by Pretty Report. Soon after, Good Time Idol cruise to the front. It's out by two. Pretty Report to second. Third was Panorama Topic, followed by Reebok Glass, who went very wide on the turn out of the straight. King Turtle the fence, followed by Duchess Tiffany for Miss Dera, Jolly Good Fox, and dropping to the rear was Reebok Glass. Halfway down the back straight, it's Good Time Idol out by two. Pretty Report's hot in pursuit. Two and a half third. Panorama Topic, followed by Duchess Tiffany, King Turtle and Miss Dera. They straighten. Good Time Idol gets away again. It's out by three, holding Pretty Report. It's all Good Time Idol. Good Time Idol wins well. Second was Pretty Report. Third, Panorama Topic, followed by King Turtle, Jolly Good Fox, Duchess Tiffany, Miss Dera, and last of all was Reebok Glass.
Okay, thank you, Rod. Now,
Mobile swings down the back, getting towards the starting point. The line is good. Blue light flashing, they're off and running. Berliner and Prince of Hanover beat them out with Tiger Trick out. Chelsea Square began well. Carnaby Hanover going up along the rail. Arby Lumber out wide, followed by Bavarian Band. Arby Lumber's put in a bad one, dropped the last. Next to last was Flashwood Trick in company with Valley's Babe. The pace fairly solid as they cast the home turn astern, where Sweeney has Tiger Trick bowling along out in front. Over Berliner, Prince of Hanover on the rail. On its outside, Carnaby Hanover. They were being followed along then by Barbarian Band in behind them, flying in style from Flashwood, Trick out Chelsea Square, and Valley's Bay board up the rear. Short of two to go as they make the run out of the straight, and Tiger Trick, the leader, over Berliner. They were being followed then out wide by Carnaby, Hanover, Berber, Prince of Hanamar, Bavarian Band, in behind those flying in style, followed by Flashwood, Trick, and Valley's Bay together, and out Chelsea Square dropped the last. The field packing up as they travel the back about 1,200 out, and Tiger Trick still showed the way out in front from Carnaby, Hanover, Berliner down on the rail. Over and behind those now was Prince of Hanamar, followed by Bavarian Band. One moving up around them, flying in style from Valley's Bay, Flashwood Trick, and still out Chelsea Square, brought up the rear. At the turn, a lap and a quarter left before them, and no change in the order as Tiger Trick by half a length to the good of Carnaby, Hanover. Berliner was down on the rail in advance of Prince of Hanamar, Bavarian Band flying in style. Valley's Bay, Flashwood Trick, and out Chelsea Square, brought up the rear. Making the run down to the judge now, with the bell lap coming up, and Tiger Trick was still in charge over Carnaby, Hanover. It's had a hard run out wide. Next was Berliner from Prince of Hanamar, Bavarian Band flying in style. Valley's Babe was third last, Flashwood Trick second last, and our Chelsea Square was last. 600 left to travel, and still Tiger Trick giving plenty out in front, was three parts of a length to Carnaby, Hanover. Berliner was third on the inside of Prince of Hanamar. Next, Bavarian Band from flying in style. Valley's Babe's on the rail and can't get out. Flashwood Trick and our Chelsea Square commencing a run from the tail of the field. 400 left to travel. Tiger Trick the leader from Carnaby, Hanover. Prince of Hanamar, Berliner out now, going after them, followed by Valley's Bay, Bavarian Band, out wide out Chelsea Square from flying in style, and Flashwood Trick, the pacer cracker as they turn the corner, and Tiger Trick the leader from Carnaby, Hanover, Berliner, Prince of Hanamar, Valley's Bay right up along the rail, but Tiger Trick in front halfway down the straight and they won't get to it. Tiger Trick won the money, Carnaby, Hanover second, all close for third, Berliner or Valley's Bay from Prince of Hanamar, Bavarian Band out Chelsea
okay,
Square.
Okay, well let's pick them up now in the back straight as we join Terry.
Merchant Joe, Paragon Peel now peels out three deep. Two lengths to Viking's Memory, then Force One and Kirahapo Princess, a long last. Wipe off in front at the 400 metres mark. Skinner's Regrets flat. Paragon Pearl's running on, going after the leader. It looks a race in two. Wipe off a length and a quarter in front of Paragon Pearl as they come to the last bend. They're clear of Skinner's Regret and Force One. Wipe off turns in front. Ducks has to go for Paragon Pearl. She's still coming after Wipe Off. Wipe Off in front with 100 to go. Paragon Pearl's grinding away. Wipe Off's tied. Paragon Pearl won't reach Wipe Off. Wipe Off wins. Wipe Off beat Paragon Pearl. Force One third from Skinner's Regret. Then Viking's Memory, Merchant Joe and Kirahapo Princess a furlong away at the tail.
All right, 6-2-1. Albion.
Set to go. Racing. Tarango Slow on the outside. Pippi Long Socks has been able to lead clearly from Western Lace and Ballygo Beauty along the rails. Duralite is getting into a nice position. A couple. Tarango, Major Mo offers charm. Further back in the field, Ballygo Beauty, he got into bother and so did Candyman Kent and they tail the field. Pippi Long Socks in front by two lengths to Duralite. Western Lace along the rails. Tarango starting to motor home powerfully behind the Major Mo. Pippi Long Socks has been able to get away. Tarango second. Pippi Long Socks the leader stopping. Tarango wearing it down, but Pippi Long Socks wins it a neck to Tarango. Third tight, Western Lacer offers charm. Right up behind the Major Mo, Ballygo Beauty, and then Candyman Kent and Duralite was last to complete the course.
8-1 in a photo there, race 2 at Winnie Park. Thank you, Pete. 8-1 in a photo.
Racing. And Demon Rob began quickly in the centre. Will head across Tarleton, Laddin, Port Morris. Cut the caper, going hard into the first turn. Muckley Might's trying to ease across from out wider, but Port Morris kicks her on the inside of it. Trap wide is Dialer Buckets, easing back through the pack. Parley's Pride in the centre. Back along the inside, settling is New Murdoch. Sir Talk Lot back second last. And 5 metres away at the tail on settling down is Marion Looney. They straighten up the first time around, and the leader is Demon Rob. Clear by 5 metres, cut the caper, able to drop to the rails in second placing. Muckley Might, I think, look to drop to the inside there, but there wasn't room. And he looks around for a trail, none coming. Tarleton and Lad, 3 back the rails, 1 out and 1 back is Port Morris. They are followed further back in the field then by New Murdoch on the inside of Parley's Pride. Then on the outside, Sir Talk a Lot, Marion Looney gets through on its inner, and Tyler Buck now last of all. They head towards the back straight, 46.3 the lead time. That's spot on 2 minute time in the early stages. And Demon Demon Rob leads into the back straight by 5 or 6 metres. In second placing on the rails, Cut the Caper. Muckley Might, the driver, still looking around, but there's no trails coming. On the inside, Tarlet and Ladd. They are followed further back in the field then by Port Morris, which has been in the 1-1 most of the way. Further back in the field then, on the inside would have been New Murdoch covering it in turn. Parley's Pride, another 2 metres away then to Sir Talk-A-Lot, still sitting on its back. Dialer Buck, Marion Looney the inside. They swing onto the home turn, a lap and a quarter from home, no quarter time there. And the leader is Demon Rob. Here it comes, the first quarter run in 32.1. So they haven't gone that hard that quarter. Demon Rob led, Sir Talk-A-Lot takes off now. Dialer Buck follows it. Sir Talk-A-Lot moves up strongly out three deep. Muckley Might kicks up in the centre. On the rails, Cut the Caper, Port Morris on the outside. Then Tarlet and Ladd. Dialer Buck follows Sir Talk-A-Lot home in the centre. Then Parley's Pride now held up. Wider out, Marion Looney. And then last of all, New Murdoch past the 600. Demon Rob kicks away, going into the back straight. 6 metres, Muckley Might's under pressure. On the inside, Cut the Caper about to get into the clear. Sir Talk-A-Lot coming forward quickly now, and Dialer Buck is tracking it home. Further back in the field then to Tarlet and Ladd. Marion Looney from a long way back coming off the back straight, and Demon Rob joined by Sir Talk-A-Lot. Dialer Buck is still running on the inside behind them, Cut the Caper, and further back in the field, New Murdoch from a long way back. Parley's Pride held up on the turn. Demon Rob and Sir Talk-A-Lot in third placing. Dialer Buck running on New Murdoch. Demon Rob finding something. He has to get busy on Sir Talk-A-Lot. Demon Rob, Sir Talk-A-Lot. Demon Rob kicking. Sir Talk-A-Lot just doing enough and he scores. Sir Talk-A-Lot, he was pretty easy on him in the straight, but he's beaten Demon Rob. Dialer Buck possibly third. New Murdoch's been a big run close up in the photo. Then Cut the Caper. They were followed home by Marion Looney, Tarlet and Ladd. Parley's Pride, I'd say, didn't have much luck in the last lap from Muckley Might. And one of the last ones in Port Morris. Please one.
Okay, well, I reckon 11's got there, so Talk a Lot it has over them.
Eight fielders set. Ready for a start in the fourth. Bunny up to the boxes. Racing. Jessica Bale won the start over Jessica Casey, the middle, Mary Fawn. Silver Rocket out wide. Jessica Casey charges up in the middle from Jessica Bale, the fence, and takes the lead out of the straight. It's Jessica Casey racing away. It's two lengths in front. Silver Rocket moves to second. Two lengths third was Jessica Bale, followed by Dance Kissing Magic Mabel and Mary Fawn at the top turn. And Jessica Casey is out by three. Silver Rocket working hard second. Three lengths third, Jessica Bale, but around the home turn, it's all Jessica Casey streaking away in the Oaks. Jessica Casey wins by five. Second, Silver Rocket. Third was Jessica Bale, followed by Mary Fawn. Second last, Magic Mabel. And last of all was Dan's Kissing.
Well, there she's done it again. Jessica Casey in race number four. The Penrith Oaks going to Jessica Casey and picking up yet another big prize.
Roughly in the score up. Change down. Ben Lohman is looking for the lead from Romp and Campbell. Ben Lohman's going to try and get across in front of Romp and Campbell as they go past the winning post two laps out. He's run wide going out of the straight though, and Graham Land kicks up on Romp and Campbell. Ben Lame on his outside, but Romp and Campbell's going to keep him out. And into the back, Romp and Campbell leads by 2 metres to Ben Lohman, which went roughly out of the straight. Dropping in on the fence, Star Viking to third, then changed down. The pace was on early. Sharp Play got to fifth, about 5 metres away, then two and sixth placing Windshield Star. Getting up along the inside was Vesta's Best, and about 15 metres away, back of the tail, Tuxedo Time with Vesta's Best. And the horse that's running third last, though, as they run off the back, Lawrence Apollo. About 1,300 metres to travel, and Rompin Campbell led. It held out Ben Lohman from the first turn and leads by 3 metres now. Third, Star Viking, the fence, one by one, was changed down. Three back the rail was Sharp Play. Moving up on its outside, Windshield Star, and four back on the rails. As they approached the home turn was Lawrence Apollo. Then came Vesta's Best, Tuxedo Time, and last of all, Waverley Bromac. Coming down the straight now with a bit over a circuit to go, Rompin Campbell in front, led 3 metres. Ben Lohman sitting without cover, second the favourite. Third over on the inside, Star Viking. One out and one back, and fourth placing change down. Three back the rail, Sharp Play, and then Windshield Star, Tuxedo Time, let's go, three wide from the rear. Then came Lawrence Apollo on the inside of Vesta's Best, and Waverley Bromac last of all. Out of the straight, they go into the back for the final time, 750 metres to travel, and Rompin Campbell on top for Graham Lang by 2 metres to Ben Lohman and John Caldo. They're the two favourites. Third, the inside, Star Viking. One out, one back, change down, fourth for the moment. Tuxedo Time going around them three wide, but under a little bit of pressure. Then Windshield Star, the centre, over on the inside, and badly held up with Sharp Play, and the sprinters on down the back. Vesta's Best back towards the tail with Lawrence Apollo, Waverly Bromac. 400 metres left to go. Ben Lehman gets on terms with Romp and Campbell. Coming at them three wide was Changed Down, and they were followed on the fence by Star Viking, needing a run. Windshield Stars under pressure. Up to the turn, 250 metres left to travel. Ben Lehman went to the front. Romp and Campbell under pressure on the inside. Changed Down running on. Then